Welcome to the screencast that will give you a short overview about the features in PHPEdit 3.0. When you start PHPEdit for the first time, you will see many improvements that we implemented into the interface. There are various places where PHPEdit will give you a short inline help about a feature you might want to use. Each help will provide you with links where you can learn more about a specific feature. Most of them are stored inside our community at phpedit.net. We implemented many new features, but of course the well-known features from previous versions are still available. If you would like to debug your PHP scripts, you can use our debugger configuration wizard to set it up. Just answer the simple questions from the wizard and debugging will work, no matter what existing environment you use. PHP also ships with an internal web server. You can request your scripts from your local machine and even debug them from within your browser window. There is no need for a remote server and you can start the debugging session right from within PHPEdit. If you would like to see exactly what is going on in your code, you can set breakpoints and PHPEdit will pause the execution at that line. Now you can inspect all the variables inside your script. With the watches dog, you are also able to see changes as they appear. With the various step features, you can walk through each line or step over function executions. If you would like to know more about this feature, we would recommend you to watch the related screencast. If you are done with inspecting the execution, just disable the breakpoint and continue the script. When profiling was enabled, PHPEdit will allow you to see the exact timings for the latest script. You will be able to see which function took the most time and which might need some improvements. You could also use our Firefox Xdebug toolbar to start a debug session. You can enable the debug feature on demand and PHPEdit will handle it for you. Our editor component will allow you to be more efficient while you write new applications or scripts. You can, for example, split the current file horizontally or vertically to see multiple locations of the same file at the very same time. As in every great editor, you can change the encoding of the files on the fly. Just choose the required ones from the complete list and save the file again. There is no need to reopen the file. PHPEdit 3.0 also has support for code collapse. You can collapse currently unimportant blocks to focus on the more important ones. If you need to see code of the collapsed blocks, you can check the tooltip or uncollapse it. To see all the details for this feature, we recommend you to watch the related screencast for code collapse. With our keyboard templates, you will be more efficient while you write code. Templates will help you to insert standard blocks into the code. Just type in the shortcut or choose it from code inside and it will be expanded. As almost any feature in PHPEdit, keyboard templates are highly configurable and you can of course change the existing ones or create new ones. There is also a screencast which can give you a deeper insight of this great feature. PHPEdit also ships with a feature called FTP Explorer. You are able to open files from remote FTP and SFTP servers. When you use the File Open dialog, you can choose the FTP section and quick connect to an unconfigured server. Just enter the connection data, test the connection, and click on OK. Now you can choose between the files as if they would be local ones. When you open the file, all the well-known features like code collapse, code hint, keyboard templates, and code inside are available, just as if it would be a local one. When you are finished with your changes and you save the file, PHPEdit will automatically upload the file content to the server. Sometimes you will work from the same remote server multiple times. You can save the servers inside PHPEdit. Open the remote server list inside the preferences and add your new server. Again, you are able to enter your connection data, maybe test the connection and save it. The FTP Explorer doc will give you access to the files of all your configured servers. Just browse through the list as if they were local files. Double-click a file to open it, make your changes, and save it. PHPEdit will do all the rest, including downloading the file and uploading the changes later. PHPEdit 3.0 also has support for projects. Projects are a collection of files and folders which belong to one application or website. When you have created a project, you can access all the related files inside the Solution Explorer doc. There are two different types of directories. virtual ones, and real ones. Real folders are stored inside the file system. You can also open them with the Windows Explorer or other tools. Virtual folders do not really exist inside the file system. You can use them to group your files. For example, I have created a virtual folder to have a shortcut for all include files of this project. You can see the difference between the folder types with the icon. Virtual folders are orange. When you are inside a project, some of the PHPEdit features will get even more enhanced. You will, for example, be able to use code inside for all the functions, classes and methods from the whole project. The Solution Explorer has also support for the FTP Explorer. You can use PHPEdit in your workflow to publish files and roll projects to a remote FTP or SFTP server. Use the Publish feature from within the Solution Explorer, choose a server, and define a location where the project should be published to. PHPEdit will do all the work for you. When the task is finished, you can see your published project on the remote server. When you need to work with SQL servers, PHPEdit can make you more efficient too. You can configure your existing SQL servers inside the preferences, just like FTP servers. Choose a database driver and enter the connection data. Test if the connection was successful and browse through the existing databases. When you press OK, the connection is saved and you will be able to use it from within the Database Explorer. You can open the server, see all tables and columns inside them. From within the context menu, you can also browse the content of the database. This will use the default query to get all the data from the table. If you would like to see the used query, just switch to code view. You can use the query builder to modify the query. Choose the desired columns, or for example, add an expression to a query. All these features are even available when you create a new SQL file. Inside the code view, you are able to modify the SQL code by hand, with all features like code insight and syntax highlighting. When you switch to the query builder, you can run your new query and see the results. PHPEdit has many more features which will help you with your daily work. Contextual help, for example, will give you the documentation for the current word which is selected or active. It is the most easiest way to see the original documentation for a function. The automatic syntax checker will inform you whenever there is a problem with your current file. It will give you the error of PHP and you will be able to solve the issue. The code browser can give you a great overview about the classes, methods and functions that are currently opened inside PHPEdit. When you found the right method, double-click it to jump to the definition. The integrated search and replace feature can be used from multiple places to search a different set of files. You can, for example, search the current file, all open files, or just the current selection. It makes it easy for you to find the required strings and, if needed, replace them with a different string.